My name's Paul Rako. I'm here with the Atmel Edge, the show that's going to teach you about electronic design, mechanical engineering, make you a well-rounded, well-grounded engineer. Today I want to talk to you about JTAG ICE emulators. These are things that let you see inside an Atmel microcontroller or microprocessor chip as it runs. It makes it much, much easier to figure out what your program is doing as it executes. We've got a whole selection of Atmel products that we can show you that helps you with your design. Let's get started and go through them one at a time. Okay, so you know debuggers or an in-circuit emulator is cool. Now you want to know what Atmel can do for you. We've got a whole selection that can get you started at an incredibly low price. It starts out with our little AVR Dragon here. It's an inexpensive product, it's $49, and it'll let you look inside the chip as it executes. It does all the 8-bit AVRs. I have to check, I think it does the 32 bits, AVR UC3s. Hooks up with a conventional USB to your computer. It's got a prototyping area that you can use, which is cool. But fundamentally, the way you use it, the way you're going to use this, you have pin one here. The documentation shows how you hook all this stuff up. So you get a little 10-pin connector. Now, I'm a little embarrassed to tell you, this cable didn't come with this board, and it didn't come with this little Xmega A1. So I'm not sure, you may have to order the cable. I'm not sure if we include it or these were just laying around. I picked them up in the storage room. So then this evaluation board, it's got a programmer on it and you can program the chip and watch it work and have fun. But debugger, no, that's not included on this particular eval board. Some of our eval boards do, I'll explain why. So here there's a nice little edge card connector. It's got a keyed section in the circuit board so that you can come in here, I guess like this, and then hook it up. And so, bang, there you've got, you have to run both the USB here to talk to the debugger, and now the debugger is also the programmer for the chip. You still have to keep the smaller, what is it, the mini, they call it USB, the little mini USB going to the board you're troubleshooting or the board that you're playing with. You have to supply power. It supplies 5-volt power to the board. So here for $49, you can get a debugger that'll let you watch the chip execute, let you single step through your program, let you see the effect of interrupts, and can really speed up how fast you're bringing your program or your product and the program in it into market. Now, the next step up is this JTAG ICE 3. Now, the JTAG ICE 3, it's $100, and it's a beautiful product. It's small, it's light, it's $100. In addition to doing all the AVR chips and the AVR 32-bit chips, this product will also, a little firmware upgrade, it'll do the SAM-D20 ARM Cortex M0 Plus chip that we make. So that's a beautiful thing that you can debug both 8 32-bit AVR and 32-bit ARM core with one product. It's $100. Beautiful packaging, beautiful everything. I ask my experienced pals here, my apps buddies, what's the difference? I mean, if they both do debugging, they said this will be a little bit faster. And you'll get the results quicker and it'll be a little snappier to work as you use it in Studio 6 in your development system. Now, just to show you how cool we are, this is the previous version. You know, we had the JTAG ICE 3. This is the JTAG ICE 2. We used to sell this for $400. And it would do the same chips, but we're not in the business to try to skin you for emulators or in-circuit debuggers. What we're trying to do is get you to market quicker. We make our money selling chips, so there's no profit margin. And I'm kind of proud that we reduced the price by 1/4 for the subsequent product. Now, there's one more product debugger in the series. This beauty, AVR ONE. And what an AVR ONE will do for you that the other two won't, it has trace capability. And with trace, you know, you let your program execute and then you can go back. It's not like you're setting a breakpoint to see, oh, what happened up to this point, stop it, let me look. The trace just records, it's like a log file. It tells you what's going on. So it's $600, this isn't cheap. It's hard to do trace real time at, you know, the kind of speeds our microcontrollers run. But this will do the trace if you have a really complex program, lots of interrupts, things going on, you could pick up an AVR ONE. Now, these are standalone debuggers. They, as I showed you, they hook to an existing board. If you design your own board, you can bring the same pins out that we do and then hook these debuggers to the same header and everything is going to work. The products themselves, this is a SAM20 Explained Pro. And when you see Explained, it's with an X, Explained Pro, that means there's a debugger on the board. And what's cool about the SAM20, it's an eval board with the chip with the SAM20 ARM core chip on it, but it's also got the debugger chip, so you can look inside this and watch it execute and set your breakpoints and single step and all that cool stuff. What I really love is there's a header on this, and you can come off of this board, you can bring that debugger off of this board onto your board. When you figure, you get along with your design, you design your own PCB with your own system and your own hardware, just bring those same pins out. And now you can jump off of this board, and instead of debugging the SAM20 that's on this board, it'll debug the SAM20 that's on your printed circuit board for your system. Another interesting thing, I just happened to find this out today, a SAM4S, so it's a Cortex 4, Explained. This isn't an Explained Pro, but because it's the 4S, it just happens to have a debugger on it as well. So whether you get a standalone debugger, you're doing the tiny AVRs or something like that, you can use our STK600 and one of these debuggers to program and debug the things. You can use an Explained Pro card. You could use some of the Explained boards that have a debugger on them, but it's going to be so much faster than trying to write printf, you know, do a little flag, I used to call it, put a flag in your program and write something out the serial port, a register value, a memory location, to try to figure out where your program's going, why it's not doing what you expect. Looking inside the chip and watching it work, just, it's a whole different world, and I can't encourage you enough to investigate getting some of these debuggers. So there you have it, that's some Atmel JTAG ICE Debug 101. We're going to continue on. We're going to start hooking this up. We've got a Camtasia hooked to a Windows 7 box. We'll fire up Studio 6. We'll show you what happens when you hook this stuff up, get you familiar with how these debuggers work, and hopefully play around with some problems and some programs where we can show you what a leg up it gives you compared to just, you know, hunt and peck and shoot things out the printf port. Thank you very much. This is the Atmel Edge. I'm Paul Rako. Tune in next time. We'll have more stuff to keep you well-grounded and well-rounded. Thank you. Hi, earlier on, I mentioned that there's technically a difference between an in-circuit emulator, an ICE, and a debugger. And to demonstrate that, I went in my home lab, and I got 20 years old. This is from 1999. An ICE 200 that I bought from Atmel when I fell in love with Atmel chips back in 99. And that was the deal. It was $200 for a real in-circuit emulator. Remember, the Intel Blue Boxes were like 50 grand when they came out for the 8051s and stuff. So this is an in-circuit emulator in the true sense of the word. Here. A debugger. What it does is it uses the real production chip, the chips that you use, and there's JTAG on it, Joint Test Action Group, that can go in and query the registers and display them for you, and you can see what's going on inside the chip. An in-circuit emulator isn't using a real chip. It's got some FPGA or some real powerful chip, runs much faster, that's emulating the Atmel chip that you plug in to this socket. So whatever Atmel chip that has these many pins, you'd pull that chip out of your system, you'd plug this in, hook this is old school, so it's back to the serial port days. And then with this ICE in-circuit emulator, you could watch the program run. Now the debuggers are much more common. We do make a JTAG ICE, which is a standard JTAG in-circuit emulator that you can use with our MPU products, the SAM7, the SAM5. There are several companies that make them. I like ours, but I'm an Atmel person. So the subtle difference, people are kind of sloppy. One of the things confused me here, when a programmer says, well, the debugger, they're talking about the thing on your PC screen, the part of Studio 6 that's running and displaying for you. Eclipse will do it, display the contents of the registers and whatnot. To a hardware guy like me, the debugger is the JTAG interface and the hardware card and these debugger systems. So watch that. Don't get too upset. Sometimes people call it an ICE now. Sometimes people call it a debugger. Either way, it's going to speed your time to market. And I can't encourage you enough to get into this so you can watch your program, no matter you think, oh, it's 40 lines of assembly language. You'll still need it. Things will go wrong. And once again, if you have interrupts or anything complex, you've got to have a debugger to help you figure out what's going on. Any code you do, even stringing together chunks of code, it really helps. So Paul Rako, Atmel Edge, hope you learned a little bit. Like I say, we'll be going further into this. This is 101 debugger. We're going to get debugger 102, 3, 4, and demonstrate all this hardware along with some screen capture stuff so you can watch it work in Studio 6, our integrated development environment. Thank you for watching. Tune in next time.